All right, students, so welcome back after your Dashera vacations, and today is the day to get ahead with the curriculum of your post half yearly syllabus. I believe most of the teachers have already started on Saturday itself, right? Yes. How many of you were there?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, nice response. So we are going to start with the chapter. This is Jodi's Fawn, and this we have already read. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Children, is the screen visible to you?
No, ma'am.
Okay.
No, ma'am.
Right. Now? Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the catch is that what and how we shall be revising this chapter. If the teacher will keep on speaking, the learners are going to make a burrow for themselves under the ground, right? So one by one, I'll be calling some beautiful and handsome hunks from this class on the mic, and then people who are sitting at their home, they will be called to lead the explanation. Right? So have you understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so firstly, I should call. Is any volunteer there in my class? Thankfully, I have pretty girls, huh? They have always raised. Okay, Angel, right? Beginning with Angel. After Angel, it will be Rituraj. And after Rituraj, it will be Mahima.
Jodi allowed his thoughts to draft back to the farm. He could not keep it out of his mind. He had held it in his dreams. In his arms, he slipped from the table and went to his father's bedside. Benny lay at rest. His eyes were open and clear, but the pupils were still dark and dilated. Jodi said, "How are you feeling, Pa?"
"Just fine, son. Old death has gone thriving elsewhere, but wasn't it a close slave?"
"I agree," Penny said. "I'm proud of you, boy. The way you kept your head at and did what you was need."
"Pa."
"Yes, son."
"Pa, do you recollect the doe and fawn?"
"I can never forget them. The poor doe was saved me. That contain."
"Pa, the fawn was may be."
"Maybe out there yet. It may be hungry and very scared."
"I suppose so."
"Pa, I am a big boy now and do not need to drink milk. Why don't you I'll go and see. If I can find the fun and bring it here and rise it." Penny lay quite starting and killing, "Boy, you have got me hemmed in it."
Thank you, Angel. So that was Angel, and she has probably started the chapter. I would invite Saba Kareem to explain what and how many characters do we have. Saba, join us.
The main character is Jodi, and in this story, Jodi's father.
Good. And the setup?
Jodi's father is ill.
All right, so Ritu, who is this Jody and how come the title is associated with the chapter? Can you throw some light on it?
Ma'am, what is the question?
How come the title is associated with the characters and the setup of the story? Jody's fawn. Throw some light on that.
Ma'am, the fawn's mother has helped his father to get treatment.
Okay, so in a way, you don't have to reveal everything. You can just throw some little bit of light. So that those who are not there in the online class when we had finished it, they may still get interested. Okay, we have to cover it. What is happening?
Ma'am, so Jody is in search of that fawn. To care for him,
Okay, anybody from online class can answer this? How the title is relevant with the characters?
Ma'am, may I tell Poonam?
Okay, Poonam.
Ma'am, in this story, the title is "This is Jody's Fawn," means that Jody's father was ill and the mother of fawn saved his father. So he is in search of Jody's fawn, and then he is taking care of the fawn after that. So that is why the title is Jody's Fawn.
Okay, do you agree that the child is very much emotionally attached with this fawn? What could be the reason behind it?
Ma'am, because the fawn is might be starving in the forest and scared, and also her mother saved his father's life, so he is very emotional about that.
There is a loss which has occurred to whom? Fawn. And that fawn is a creature, and to that creature the child is feeling indebted, right? That we have taken the help, and now yes, to return the favor by caressing the animal, by looking after the animal, right? So let us move ahead with the chapter, and somebody from online class can volunteer to read the next of the lines.
Ma'am, okay. May I, Poonam?
Okay, anybody else from Poonam, as Poonam has just interacted with us? So it is very pretty sure that she's quite active, yeah. Anybody else?
Khushi.
Ma'am, may I?
Okay, Khushi, begin. I'll be asking you one by one.
Okay, ma'am. Penny lay quiet, staring at the ceiling. Boy, you have got me hemmed in. It won't take much to raise it. Pa, it will soon start eating leaves and acorns. You are smarter than boys of your age. We took its mother, and it wasn't to blame. Surely it seems ungrateful to leave it to starve. Son, I can't say no to you. I never thought I had lived to see another day. Can you ride back with Millwill and see if I can find it? Tell your ma I said you can go. He slid back to the table and sat down. His mother was pouring coffee for everyone. He said, Ma, Pa says I can go bring back the fawn. She held the coffee pot in the midair. What fawn? The fawn belonging to the doe we killed. We used the doe's liver to draw out the poison and save Pa. She gasped. Well, for pity's sake, Pa says it would be ungrateful to leave it to starve. Doc Wilson said, That's right. Ma'am, nothing in the world comes quite free. The boy's right and his dad is right. Millwill said, he can ride back with me. I will help him find it. She set down the pot helplessly. Well, if you will give it to your milk, we have got nothing else to feed it. Millwill said, come on, boy. We have
Pause. So here the nature of the mother is not very much familiar for this fawn, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
She is not very likable to, in the favor of bringing that animal to home. Why so?
Ma'am, because his mother think that he don't have anything to feed the fawn.
Only this concern she has. That is what literature.
Ma'am, because we have took the help. They have took the help of the fawn's mother.
He have. Ma'am, structure आपका अच्छा होना चाहिए. He has.
No, ma'am, he has.
हाँ. All right. So beyond the text, if I ask you to go beyond the text, do you have people in your life where you have come across that actually the kind of intention which we carry, we are actually not getting the same from the other people, and it happens many a times that those people are very much there in our family. Yes or no? So how do you tackle that
yes.
situation? Do you battle with them? Okay, Kirti says
no,
yes, ma'am. But I think there can be some other ways, substitutes. Directly indulging with your father,
to
mother,
get the return favor.
Sorry,
ma'am. Like to get the favor in return.
Yeah. So how can you persuade the person to get agree with you? Will you be very violent, aggressive?
No.
Especially,
no, ma'am.
Especially when
ma'am,
that
by communication we can have it.
Okay, and how that communication will go? Some example. Give me some real life situation. Prashant sir. Animal should be brought home, but actually she made it clear by stating some facts. That what is that fact? One of the students said about something about milk. She made it very clear that the supply of milk will be limited. Hai na Rajneesh? Okay. Khushi, you may go ahead.
Okay, ma'am. Ma Baxter asked anxiously, "You will not be gone long." Jody said, "I will be back before dinner for sure." Millville mounted his horse and pulled Jody up behind him. He said to Millville, "Do you think the fawn's still there? Will you help him find him?" "We will find him if he's alive. How you know it's a he? The spots we are all in a line. On a doe fawn, Pa says the spots are very every which way."
Pause. Okay. So what is the gender of this doe? Fawn? She or he?
A male.
Ma'am, he is a male.
It's a masculine gender, right? The explanation is just explained. Read by Khushi. Is it clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Now I shall invite. Now I shall invite. Aditya. It was Mahima's turn. Okay, Mahima, come. Mahima, then Aditya, and then somebody from the online class.
Sumit.
Jody gave himself over to thoughts of the pawn. They passed the abandoned clearing. He said,
abandoned
clearing. He said, "Cut to the north, Mindwheel." It was up here that Pa was got bitten by the snake and killed the doe. And I saw the pawn. Suddenly, Jody was unwilling to have Millville with him. If the fawn was dead or could not be found, he could not have his disappointment seen. And it was the fawn was there. The meeting would be so lovely and so secret that he could not endure to share it. He said, "It's not far now. But the scrub is very thick for a horse. I can make it on foot. But I'm afraid to leave you, boy. Suppose you got lost or got bitten by the snake too? I will take care. It might take me long time to find the fawn if he's wandered. Leave me off right here. All right, but you take it easy now. You know north here and east. There and there. That tall pine makes a bearing. So long. So long, Melville. I'm obliged. Obliged. He waited for the second of the who's. He waited for the sound of the who's to end. Then cut to the right. The scrub was still. Only his own crackling twigs sounded across the silence. He wondered for an intense instant if he had mistaken his direction. Then a buzzard rose in front of him and flapped into the air. He came into the clearing under the oaks. Buzzard sat in a circle around the carcass of the door. They turned their heads on their long, scrawny necks and hissed at him. He knew his bow at he threw his bow at them, and they flew into an adjacent tree. Their sand showed large cat prints, but the big cat killed fish, and they had left the door to the carrion birds.
So that was Mahima, and she has read a part where the ongoings of this adventure, what is happening actually, which action sequence is going on, which event is occurring at the moment. People like Ravikant can help us. Hana Ravikant, what is happening? I think the little child has gone into the forest area to look for the fawn. And are they close to the fawn? Have they found any traces? I guess no, they are still looking.
Yes, okay. Ma'am.
Huh. So now they are very much, especially the younger one is very much determined to find the fawn on his own like an individual, right? He's pretty confident. And now I would invite Aditya. After that, Sumit will read the part.
Yes, ma'am.
He parted the grass at the place where he had seen the fawn. It did not seem possible that it was only yesterday. The fawn was not there. He circled the clearings. There was no sound, no sign. The buzzards clacked their wings, impatient to return to their business. He returned to the spot where the fawn had emerged and dropped on all fours, studying the sand of the small hoof prints. The night's rain had washed away all tracks except those of cat and buzzards.
Go on.
Next. Movement directly in front of him startled him so that he tumbled backward. The fawn lifted its face to his. It turned its head with a white. Movement directly in front of him startled him so that he tumbled backward. The fawn lifted its face to his. It turned its head with a wide, wondering motion and shook him through with the stare of its liquid eyes. It was... No, what's that? Quivering. It made no efforts to rise or run. Jody could not trust himself to move. He whispered, "It's me." The fawn lifted its nose, scenting him, he reached out one hand and laid it on the soft neck. The touch made him delirious. He moved forward on all fours until he was close beside it. He put his arms around its body. A light convulsion passed over it, but it did not stir.
So convulsion here stands for shiver. What does this mean? Is it an action word? I want to know from you people. Dear, what's your good name? Loudly. Ankush Tripathi. Are you Ankush? Okay, Ankush, it is written Shiva, right? Do you know the meaning of Shiva? If you know, you may say yes, ma'am. If you don't know, you may say, ma'am, I don't know. That's okay. Have a seat. Who can Mehak? Would you like to try? The meaning is given on the text itself. You need to just contextualize it. I'm just asking you to vakya mein prayog karo. Huh? How do you contextualize? वहाँ पे लिख दिया, आपने समझ लिया, उसे आप contextualize कर रहे हैं, जहाँ पे वो word use हुआ है, उसे आप meaning put कर रहे हैं, meaning making कर रहे हैं. आयुष विल से, है ना आयुष? ओके, सो डू यू शिव एवर व्हेन?
यस मैम, व्हेन वी आर नर्वस.
ओके, खुशी सेज व्हेन इट इज विंटर्स, व्हेन वी आर नर्वस, पीपल आर रिस्पोंडिंग इन डिफरेंट वेज.
यस मैम.
Ma'am, shivering from cold.
Correct.
Ma'am, if we are scared of something.
Very nice, very nice. Now you are very close to the actual meaning. When we are actually scared of something, and do you feel that that degree of scariness is more than normal? Hum kab itne scared ho jate hain ki hume shivering ho jati hai, bhai, ya hum shiver karne lagte hain? I think it is. Who Shiva? All right, so I think you all have understood. Let us go ahead. Any doubt?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Chalo, ma'am.
Sumit, now you start reading.
Yes, ma'am. So, he stroked its sides as gently as though the fawn were a china deer and he might break it. Its skin was very soft. It was sleek and clean and had a sweet scent of grass. He rose slowly and lifted the fawn from the ground. Its legs hung limply. They were surprisingly long and he had to hoist the fawn as high as possible under his arm. He was afraid that it might kick and bleed at sight and smell of its mother. He skirted the clearing and pushed his way to the thicket. It was difficult to fight through this burden. The fawn's legs caught in the bushes and he could not lift his own with freedom. He tried to shield its face from prickling vines. Its head bobbed with his stride. His heart thumped with the marvel of acceptance of him. He reached the trail and walked as fast as he could until he came to the intersection with the road home. He stopped to rest and set the fawn down on dangling legs. It wavered on them. It looked at him and bleated. He said, "Enchanted. I'll carry you after I get my breed." He remembered his father saying
Pause. B-R-E-A-T-H. How do you pronunciate it?
Ma'am, breed.
It should be breathe. Breathe. Okay? And when you take a breath, when you inhale, take a breath inside your diaphragm. So then there you say breath, bad okay. Breath, good breath, hai na? Breathing pattern, breathe, all right?
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah,
he remembered his father saying that a fawn would allow if it had first been carried. Stared away slowly, the fawn started after him, stared after him. He came back to it and stroked it and walked away again. It took few wobbling steps towards him and cried piteously. It was willing to follow him. It belonged to him. It was his own. He was lightheaded with joy. He wanted to fondle it, to run and romp with it, to call it to it, to come to him. He dared not to alarm it. He picked it up and carried it in front of him over his two arms. It seemed to him that he walked without effort.
Pause. Who can explain the meaning of these lines? People from online. Akansha, Arav, Garvika, who else? Nishkarsh. Bahut sare bachche hain bhai. Utkarsh also. Anybody would like to take the lead and explain? Is the child happy now? Has he found the young one? A moment ago, we were speculating and we were still struggling with the description of the author, the way he is putting every scene ahead before the readers, that how the child is making his best foot forward in finding the little animal, right? So now he has actually found it and he's elated with joy. So what is coming next? What are these two people doing? What's your good name, dear? Kushal Pandey, huh? Kindly participate, say something. Prashansa?
Haan? Ma'am, may I?
Haan. What's your good name?
Khushi.
Okay, Poonam, now you may explain.
Ma'am, now the boy had found the fawn and he is carrying the fawn. But after some time, the boy was also very tired and he is kept comforting the fawn because he is China deer and his skin is very soft and delicate. And he is very scared that he can broke his bones. Mm-hmm. And after that, he is...
So what do you think, Poonam, in short, what do you think, what these two are going to do now?
Ma'am, where are they heading? Boy is protecting where are the fawn and carrying. Ma'am, towards home.
Okay, thank you, Poonam, for responding in time. Alright, so I think this much is enough for today. And whatever part is left, you are expected to learn it, go through the lines, read it on your own. And tomorrow, I shall be discussing the question and answers in the class. Any doubt?
No, ma'am.
This is the revision which I am carrying of this chapter and this is already taught. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.